So let us extend how to prepare dinitrogen monoxide, nitrogen monoxide, dinitrogen trioxide, nitrogen dioxide, N2O4, that means dinitrogen tetroxide and dinitrogen pentoxide. So let us have, during the preparation of dinitrogen monoxide, ammonium nitrate, NH4NH3, ammonium nitrate. So ammonium nitrate, when heated, that means we can call it as thermal decomposition of ammonium nitrate, can yield us the formation of N2O. When 2 moles of, so from here we are going to write the preparation. So these are the oxidation states of nitrogen in the respected oxides, and this is the way of preparation of the respected oxides from the nitrogen. So 2 moles of ammonium nitrate, when undergoes thermal decomposition, it yields us the formation of nitrous oxide plus ammonia plus 2 moles of water, H2O. Similarly, let us have how to produce nitric oxide or nitrogen monoxide in the laboratory. It is produced from 3 moles of sodium nitrite, NaNO2, when reacted with 3 moles of sulfuric acid, it produces 3 moles of sodium bisulfate plus 2 moles of nitric oxide plus 1 mole of HNO3 plus 1 mole of water. So the most important things are these here, underlined by me. Thermal decomposition of ammonium nitrate produces nitrous oxide or dinitrogen monoxide as the final product or resulting product, whereas when sodium nitrite reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid, it results as the formation of nitric oxide as our product. Similarly, let us have one preparation which indicates the formation of dinitrogen trioxide. It is produced from when nitric oxide reacts with nitrogen dioxide. Once again, we are using two different types of nitrogen oxides reaction to produce another new nitrogen oxide, which indicates nitric oxide or nitrogen monoxide, when reacts with nitrogen dioxide, it produces N2O3. This reaction generally expected at 250 Kelvin temperature or 263 Kelvin temperature, whereas nitrogen dioxide, the nitrogen dioxide is produced from lead nitrate, PbNO3, taken twice. When 2 moles of lead nitrate undergoes thermal decomposition nearly at 673 kelvins of temperature. Okay, lead nitrate in its thermal decomposition are heated at 673 kelvins, it produces NO2. What it is? 4 moles of NO2 plus 2 moles of lead oxide plus 1 mole of oxygen. So this is the preparation of nitrogen dioxide, and it is the preparation of dinitrogen trioxide. Whereas let us have a look on dinitrogen tetroxide. How to produce dinitrogen tetroxide? When 2 nitrogen dioxide molecules reacts with each other, the 2 nitrogen dioxide molecules reacts with each other to produce dinitrogen tetroxide, which will be represented as N2O4 molecular formula. Similarly, dinitrogen pentoxide. Here, the dinitrogen pentoxide resulting from H3PO4 plus, sorry, here the dinitrogen pentoxide is resulting from HNO3 followed by P4O10 phosphorus pentoxide. It is called as dimer of phosphorus pentoxide, P2O5 plus P2O5. The two monomers of P2O5 reacts with each other to produce dimer. The resulting dimer is called as dimer of phosphorus pentoxide, which will be represented as P4O10. Now the P4O10 reacts with nitric acid. It is nitric acid. Finally produces HPO3 plus N2O5. HPO3 plus N2O5. We are using 4 moles of here and we finally produces 4 HPO3s plus N2O5. 2 N2O5. So this is how the preparation of nitrogen oxides expected in the laboratory. So once again, step wise, the first nitrogen oxide is N2O. The name of this compound is dinitrogen monoxide or nitrogen 1 oxide or nitrous oxide. The oxidation state of nitrogen in nitrous oxide is plus 1, which will be produced in the laboratory from thermal decomposition of ammonium nitrate. So which yields us the formation of nitrous oxide. Whereas in second one, nitric oxide, which is also represented as the molecular formula NO, nitrogen monoxide or nitrogen 2 oxide, because of nitrogen's oxidation state is plus 2. It is produced from sodium nitrite and concentrated sulfuric acid. Whereas the next one is dinitrogen trioxide, which is also called as nitrogen 3 oxide, because of oxidation state of nitrogen is plus 3 and it is resulting from the reaction between nitric oxide with nitrogen dioxide. Similarly, one more, nitrogen dioxide NO2 are also called as nitrogen 4 oxide, in which the nitrogen will show plus 4 oxidation state, and the nitrogen dioxide in the laboratory expected from the thermal decomposition of lead nitrate at 673 degree Kelvin. And next one, N2O4, it is also called as dinitrogen tetroxide or nitrogen 4 oxide. Here, why we have to use the names are same for NO2 and N2O4 are, in these two oxides, nitrogen oxides, the oxidation state of nitrogen is same, that is plus 4. Hence, the two chemical substances, NO2, N2O4, are called as nitrogen 4 oxides. And this N2O4, which is also known as dinitrogen tetroxide, produced from the dimerization or the addition of two nitrogen dioxides to yields us the formation of N2O4. Similarly, the last oxide of nitrogen N2O5, dinitrogen pentoxide, it is produced from nitric acid with dimer of phosphorus pentoxide. So this is how, what are nitrogen oxides, the general molecular formula of nitrogen oxides, and different names of nitrogen oxides, and oxidation states of nitrogen in the respected nitrogen oxides, and preparation of those nitrogen oxides in the laboratory. And the next one, let us have Lewis dot structures or geometries of nitrogen oxides. Lewis dot structures or Lewis dot structures or geometry. Structure of nitrogen oxides. Structure of nitrogen oxides. So what are nitrogen oxides? 6 nitrogen oxides are present. So all the 6 nitrogen oxides geometries we are going to represent, on the board. So those structures are Lewis dot structures. Those structures are called as Lewis dot structures. Let us have, what is the first studied, just now studied nitrogen oxide?